everybody. It's Monday, November 22nd, and joining me today is actor Eric Persullivan. He plays Dewey on the Fox show Malcolm in the Middle. Welcome.
Thanks for having me here. Let's get started with today's top story. On Friday night, the NBA became the National Basketball Association. And yesterday, 2 days after a fight involving the Indiana Pacers, the Detroit Pistons, and a number of spectators, the NBA issued some of its harshest penalties ever. Late in the game, Detroit's Ben Wallace was fouled while going up for a layup. Wallace retaliated by shoving Indiana's Ron Artest. A brief fight followed, but was broken up fairly quickly. Things were calming down until a fan threw a full cup at Artest. What followed looked more like the WWE than the NBA.
Fans, stay off the floor. You know, we gotta stay out the stands.
But neither of those two rules seemed to apply. Artest stormed into the stands and attacked a fan. So did Steven Jackson. Fans flooded the floor. And Indiana's Jermaine O'Neal slugged one of them. And as the Indiana players fled to their locker room, fans poured beverages and ice over them. Police and prosecutors looked at the tapes and warned Indiana players that they could face criminal charges.
We could look in the assault battery, aggravated assault, depending on the nature and extent of any injuries, as well as felonious assault.
On Sunday, the NBA announced its verdict. 3 Indiana players were hit hard. Ron Artest will be suspended for the rest of the season, 72 games. Steven Jackson is out for 30 games, and Jermaine O'Neal out for 25. 6 other players from the 2 teams were suspended for a total of 15 games. At one basketball court, teenage players seemed to split the blame.
I think it was all the fans' fault. They were really rowdy.
I think the players are responsible for going out there to the into the fans, into the seats. They're professionals. They shouldn't do stuff like that. The fans, they shouldn't even be throwing stuff into the court. There's no need for all that.
The NBA says that fans share the responsibility with the players for what happened Friday night. And teams around the league have been told to review their security procedures.
And in other news, over the weekend, President Bush went to Santiago, Chile, where he met with leaders of 20 Pacific Rim nations for the annual Asia-Pacific Economic Cooperation Summit. They talked about issues ranging from trade barriers to controlling diseases to fighting terrorism. The president focused on nuclear threats from North Korea.
The message is clear to Mr. Kim Jong-il. Get rid of your nuclear weapons programs.
APEC summits were started in 1989 to boost Pacific Rim trade. In Iraq, the country's interim government formally set January 30th for elections, but government officials fear escalating violence could threaten the plan. It was a weekend of gunfights, assassinations, and bombings in Baghdad. Meanwhile, U.S. troops in Fallujah say they found at least 20 sites that rebels used to torture and kill hostages.
And just ahead, Native Americans say that they're fighting for the remains of their ancestors, but museums say they're studying our past. You decide after the break.